Breakfast Show
with Nick Grimshaw.
Get up!
Oh, good morning, Adele.
Hello. Hey, hey, hey.
Good morning, Troy Sivan.
Good morning, how are you?
Wake yourself up. Good morning, everybody. It is Tuesday morning. It's just gone 8 a.m. on the Radio 1 Breakfast Show. And our guest is here. Good morning, Lord.
Hello there. How are you doing?
Hello there. I'm really good. How are you?
I'm good.
Hey, thank you for coming in to see us.
No worries. Anytime.
It's been a little while.
It's been a minute. I was trying to think of the last time I saw you and I can't remember.
I think the last time that we saw each other was you put your wet finger in my ear in Glasgow.
This is going to follow me until I die. It was dry. I just want to say.
It was dry, Willy. Still shocking.
Dry Willy. I apologize.
It was still shocking to have the finger of Lord in my ear.
It's not good. I'm so sorry.
It was a real surprise.
Yeah.
And really, whenever I see you now, no matter how cool your performance is or how great your music video is, I'm like,
think of that.
She put her finger in my ear. Well, Lord is our guest this morning on the Radio 1 Breakfast Show. We're going to be chatting more after these three songs. Radio 1 Breakfast Show
with Nick Grimshaw.
Okay, Tuesday morning, it is 8:15 and we have Lord with us. Good morning.
Hello there, how's it going?
I'm really good. It's so nice to have you on the show because I remember
really nice to be here.
I remember when you first came on.
Mm-hmm.
When was it, Fifi? 2012, 2013?
Yeah.
Something like that.
And 16.
16 years
little
old.
Baby.
I know. I remember
little
you sat
baby.
There.
Yeah.
Your mum was
very
here.
Nervous. My mum's still here. She hasn't moved. In
Has
4
she not?
Years.
Oh, wow. She's actually still in reception.
Yeah, she's just
She just
there.
Loves this building.
Yeah, she does.
Does she come everywhere and have a nice time, or does she particularly enjoy the Radio 1 Breakfast Show with Nick Grimshaw?
She deeply enjoys coming to the BBC building.
Uh-huh.
She does come to a lot of places with me, yeah. So it's nice to have a bit of mum energy around.
Yeah, I like that. Our mums won't even listen to us on the radio.
Your mum doesn't listen to you.
She'll occasionally
listen. The novelty worn off.
Yeah.
I don't hear from Nick every day, just some days.
Yeah, she's like, I don't need it in real life and on the radio. Yeah. But I heard your mum's keeping your... Like keeping your scrapbook and your memories together. Like she keeps all your passes for everywhere.
She does. She does keep a lot of my passes. Yeah, she definitely looked wolfishly at the BBC pass this morning and I teased her about it. Yeah, she keeps everything, which is so great. I feel like one day I've got to make some sort of like weird quilt.
Yeah, really weird quilt with your history on.
Yeah.
Yeah, and pass it on to your children and be like, here's some BBC passes on a duvet.
Yeah.
Just what you wanted. We've got to talk about Green Light because this is when people talk about like a comeback or like I'm back. They, you know, don't really, sometimes it doesn't happen. This song feels like a smack in the face, Green Light, doesn't it? It feels like a whole new chapter for Lord. It definitely feels like I'm back, everybody.
Right, thank you.
Was that a conscious decision to come back with like a huge banger, or was this just what happened when you went into the studio?
I mean, it's interesting because even when the song was just like on piano, it felt exactly the way it feels now. It was born so kind of such electricity to even the demo. And it felt like the start of the chapter of the record. So for that reason, I was like, it's a nice place to start. But also I feel like, and I love it, but a lot of the music on the radio is like very chill these days, which is cool. It's very cool to be very chill. And I was like quite chill, you know, Royals is like very slow. And I was like, you know what? I don't feel like being chill. I feel like being a psycho and just bursting back and being like, here it is, all of it. This is everything that I've been feeling. It's very fast. It's got a bizarre Euro piano behind it. Deal with it.
I like that though. I like the sort of the passion in it and the pace into it.
I think, it feels good.
Yeah.
It's cool.
It really does feel good. Did you like go into the studio after, you know, the success of your first album? That must have been a whole different process going into to write. So did you, because obviously you didn't have the success before the first one, and they always say like the second one is like the difficult second album.
Yeah, yeah.
How did you attack it? Like, how did you go? Did you go and sit down and be like, today I write an album, or were you always writing? Like, how does it happen for you?
I mean, you want to be able to do it like that. I mean, there's a reason I faffed around for 2.5 years. It did take me a while to get it right. But no, I mean, I think that you have an idea of what an album will be when you start, and to look back on that picture at the end, it's always very, very different. I mean, I definitely didn't know I was going to make this record influenced by all this music that I was dancing to every night, you know, but I did, and I'm glad that I did.
So is that what happened? You had time off, went dancing, and then I'm gonna make a dance banger.
So yeah, it was like I'm gonna make all this music that's like that vibe.
Yeah. Well, should we hear it?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, let's do it. Lordy's here, our guest this morning on the Radio 1 Breakfast Show. This is Green Light.
I do my makeup in somebody else's car. We ordered different...
Lord and Green Light on BBC Radio 1. And Lord is here with us this morning. That sounds good, doesn't it, on the radio?
Oh, man, I was just saying, I haven't really listened to the song on the radio before. It sounds so good.
It sounds you're like...
It's all you guys. Something you're doing is...
Yeah, it's all us. It's the way I intro'd it. That's what made it sound good.
It's that.
When you made that and it was all finished, like, do you go and play that to people and be like, do you want to hear my new massive banger that's going to be a hit all over the world? Like, do you know that... Are you confident when you made that was going to sound good on the radio?
You definitely have no idea. And a lot of people were telling me what was wrong with the song, why the song wouldn't work.
I was getting
a lot of mixed responses because the first time you listen to it, it's very confusing.
Yeah.
There's a key change mid-song, you know, this piano comes in. And I think a lot of people were just like, I think I like it. I can't really tell. Which was stressful, as you can imagine, having not put anything out in 3 years for people to be like, I don't know if this is good or not.
Yeah, they're like,
yeah. But no, it's been cool. Yeah, it was. I know, I was just so prepared for everyone to hate it.
How do you play music to people? Because it's always a weird thing.
Oh, I avoid it to the 11th hour, Nick. I'm like, I can't do this. My friends and loved ones hear things maybe even after they come out.
Oh,
my
really?
Family heard it a little while before. They had it on their iPods and they were dancing to it at home. But yeah, I don't... Because it's embarrassing. Listen to this thing that I've made. There's never the perfect moment to put on your own, to transition from other people's music to your own in the socials. Should we put this on?
Should we listen to me? Yeah. It's quite a weird thing. I'm glad that you said that because that happens occasionally with me where guests come on. It happened, Lady Gaga came in when she played Perfect Illusion.
Uh-huh.
And she's like, do you want to hear some of the albums? So I was like, I'd love to hear some of the albums.
Yeah.
Thinking maybe she'll email it me. So then she took me into that room over there.
Oh, yes. And
played it to me and just looked at me like...
Yes.
And I have to do that fake, like, I'm listening face. Like, that bit. It's so awkward.
It was more awkward for me, I think, because I just think that everything I do is terrible. I'm so self-deprecating. I mean, I know it's not... I love it, but it takes me a second to get there.
Yeah, well, I guess you can't be like, this is amazing, everybody. Everybody listen to it. What about, like, your... peers in music, because you're friends with, like, you know, the Haim girls and friends with Taylor and stuff. Do you call them, or is that even weirder because they're doing the same job, or is that nicer because they're doing the same job for musical advice?
I mean, I kind of don't really operate from a place of like listening to a lot of advice, just because I'm like, when it's right for me, my brain and what I'm going through at the moment. There's probably a better way of doing it, but to me, this feels right. But it's definitely nice to especially when, you know, I've been on a break for a long time, to just check in with other musicians and be like, how are you doing? Differently with the Haim girls, it was like, we've kind of been making our second records
at the same time.
Yeah. And so we'd have dinner every couple months and be like, you're doing all right? You're in the trenches.
How many tracks?
Yeah. Are you happy? You're eating well?
I really want to hear that Haim record.
Oh, it's all I want.
Have you heard anything?
I heard a little bit a long time ago. I'm very excited. The day it comes out, I'm putting aside the day. They're going to smash it.
They're going to smash it.
I just think they're so wonderful.
I find, like, not that I'm like your mum or anything, but I like it that you're friends with Haim and that you're in the same career. It's quite cute.
Our families have hung out at one point. Their mum and dad and my mum, we've all kind of spent time together.
I like that.
Quite sweet to think about. It's like a very familial vibe.
And I guess it's going to be good, like, if you are both on like festival circuits together. Do you know what you're doing for the summer yet? Do we have any festivals? I know you're doing Coachella.
I'm doing Coachella, yeah. I'm doing a bunch of stuff.
It's a big one at Coachella as well.
That's the first one.
Is it? Will you be nervous for that? Do you get nervous?
Oh, boy. Like, oh, yes. A lot of Rescue Remedy. Do you guys have Rescue Remedy?
Yeah, we have that. Yeah.
Indulge in a bit of Rescue Remedy. Yeah. I'm doing a... I'm so excited to start talking about it, and I know I'm not allowed to talk about anything that I'm doing yet.
Okay. Phoebe's really pushing me on this. She's just wrote down, any UK ones? We can't talk about them.
What I can say is that they're definitely UK ones.
There we go.
I'm popping my little head out. It's about when and where, and you'll have to wait to find out.
Okay, that's good, because lots of people this morning are really excited about you performing live.
Oh, man, I love performing here.
Alice has said, when are you going to tour in England? Do we know?
Proper tour. I mean, I think it's another thing. Someone's going to be standing behind us being like, don't talk about it.
Yeah, these things are planned. But
listen, they're definitely...
You like it here.
They're in my eye, Cal.
Oh.
It's all teed up.
So all we have to do
don't worry
is
about
hack
it,
her eye, Cal.
Whoa! No!
I'm just kidding.
Don't say that on
I'm just kidding. Louisa, 12-year-old Louisa says, I love Lord. Is she going to go on tour? Yes, Louisa, she is. It's in her eye, Cal. And hello to Evie on her way to school as well, saying, I love Lord so much. Her song's so amazing.
Oh, that is so sweet.
Yeah.
Little mates, isn't it?
Little mates there, all excited for the tour. But confirmation, she's going to be doing something somewhere. That's an exclusive, guys.
Yes, there we are.
What a scoop. Something's happening somewhere.
Yeah.
Hello to Don, who's been on, saying, first time I am hearing Lord speak.
Oh, hi, Don. How are you doing?
Even her spoken voice is super musical.
Oh, interesting.
says Don. And by the way, loved your performance on Saturday Night Live. Best I've seen in a long time.
Oh, thanks, guys.
That was great, wasn't
it? Everyone is so nice today. I had the best time on Saturday Night Live. It is so much fun. And I had a great week. Scarlett Johansson was hosting, which is
such a
treat. She's hosted 5 times.
Wow. She's
great. I can't even imagine hosting the one time.
Yeah.
I have no comic timing. if they ever ask, I mean, it's doubtful that they'll ask, but I'm like, I can't do it. I can't.
Sing, fine.
Like, lead balloon. It would just be the end for me.
And Saturday Night
as a
Live.
Working professional, yeah. But the performance, super fun.
The performance would be wonderful. I want to talk to you about another show as well, because you're a big fan of Saturday Night Live. But I hear also you've become recently a big fan of this.
It's just so cozy hearing this.
So cozy.
I'm seeing the opening shots.
I'm smelling the cakes. I'm dreaming of a tent in a field.
A tent.
And Mary Berry, God bless her.
Isn't she a rock star?
She's the best.
I think she's my new favorite person.
Hello, yeah.
I'm obsessed with her. And I had this thought. I was like, maybe her and the Queen of France.
Do you think?
Don't you think they would like kick it? Mary Berry and the Queen. It's not impossible.
It's not a crazy thought.
It's not a crazy thought.
We don't know if they've met. We'll do some research if they've not, they should be BFFs.
Listen, guys, I'm happy to hook you up on a friend date.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
You know
about
the Queen very well. You know Mary Berry very well. Yeah. Just makes sense.
I'm just obsessed with this show.
Me too.
I'm so grateful that I found it. I have no idea what about it makes it so incredible. But it's something, it's so cozy. It's very funny. It's very endearing. All these people from all these walks of life. I feel how people must feel watching American Idol. So nice. Who's going to win? The old man or the young child?
It's amazing. It's like American Idol with cakes or
gorgeous.
Something. Well, we're going to chat more to Lord, probably about the Great British Bake Off. After the news, it's 8:32. Here's Tina Dahili.
This is BBC Radio 1.
MP's.
Morning, everybody. It's 8:39. We have Lord with us this morning. Good morning.
Hello.
I've prepared you something.
Talk to me. What's going on?
You know you like music and you like cream eggs?
Yeah.
I've got something special for you after this.
When you're low and your knees can't rise.
Okay, 8:42 Tuesday morning. We have Lord with us. Good morning.
Hi.
Hi, Lord. Since we've, you know, played those songs and we've had the news, we have, by the way, everybody, just spoken about the Great British Bake Off.
That's it. That's all that's going on.
How are we feeling about Noel Fielding on the Great British Bake Off?
I am very excited. I love the Mighty Boosh.
Yeah, love.
Obviously, it's a change in tone. I'm excited to see what he does with the art form that is the Great British Bake Off.
I hope it's super weird.
I think it's going to be pretty weird. I think he's going to wear some crazy outfits in the tent.
Eh? Yeah, sort of cake-inspired looks for Noel Fielding. We've got to get him on the show. We've not had him on for ages.
Should have had him on today. Grilled him about that.
About what the hell was going on.
It's incredible.
Yeah. Okay.
You should be a guest star on The Great British Bake Off.
Hello, and you should.
Do they have guest stars?
We should enter it.
Should we?
We know Noel Fielding. We can text him. Okay, exclusive. Me and Lord, contestants.
Perfect.
On The Great British Bake Off. What else do you like to watch? Because I imagine when you're, you know, you've got this summer ahead of festivals, you're going to have to be stocked on like box sets and stuff.
A lot of tour TV. Yeah.
So Bake Off, obviously.
Love Bake Off.
Yeah.
And really into Big Little Lies at the moment.
I've not seen that yet.
They are good.
I need to see that.
It's just so good.
I need to see that.
What else is awesome? I feel like I love that show Love on Netflix.
I've not seen that either.
It's cool. It's really good.
I'm still watching Bake Off.
Check that one out.
And also, I hear your go-to snack, we saw you tweet about this, is you love a cream egg.
Gets to Easter time and I love to indulge in a cream egg. And I've been in America and the chocolate is not very good.
Yeah, I've heard that.
I was excited to come to the UK and snack on a little cream egg. And I can see, actually, am I allowed to pull these into
Look
the
at that.
Somebody's brought me 10 cream eggs.
I've also stole two.
There's 12, so
but I need two. Because they have got smaller, I feel, this year.
Should I have a little try one? I mean, it's very early in the morning to be eating a cream egg.
I think it's only going to enhance the interview, I feel.
Have
my hands got bigger? Because I remember when they were little, when I was little, I could never finish one. But now, I could have two of them. I mean, what is that stuff in the middle? It's not good for you.
Is it? You get your tongue in there and you hit the orange. That's the money.
I don't know what it is, but I like it.
Oh, yeah. God, that's
wow,
rich.
That's
that is rich.
Wow.
Very rich.
Wow, I'm not going to sleep till Friday. Anyway, because you like cream eggs so much, and we like green light so much, I thought I'd do you a trade-off, basically.
Okay.
Because you've written songs for us, for the world. But has anyone ever written a song for Lord?
I don't think so.
Well, hello.
I'm terrified. No, what's about to happen?
We basically combined two of our favourite things in March. Green light and also cream eggs.
Oh, my God.
Are you ready for this?
I don't know, am I?
You have some lyrics in front of you.
Oh, gosh. Okay.
Oh, my God, that was good.
It was good, eh?
Should we just end the interview here? I don't think we can top that. But I thought we could sing a song based on Green Light, all about your love of cream eggs. Do you hate this?
I hate it. No, I love it. let's give it a try.
Okay, let's give
God,
it a try.
God, these lyrics are quite good.
Yeah, do you like them?
I do. Thank you. I'm impressed.
We can work together if you want. Is the album finished?
We're getting real close.
Well, let's squeeze another track in.
Okay. Yeah,
bonus track. Okay. Don't have that because we're going to sing.
Okay.
She really likes cream eggs.
It's so delicious.
Okay.
All right.
So why don't we do line for line?
Oh, God.
Should we do that?
Okay.
Should I start?
Do we have any instrumental backing?
Hello. We've got the green light brackets breakfast cream egg edit.
Oh, my God.
Instrumental. Here we go. I rip off all the foil before I leave the shop.
I've waited all this time and now I just can't stop.
Oh, wow, your voice is good. Wait. I need them all year round. I wanna scream the truth.
I said I'd have just one. I'm such a damn liar.
The white cream, it tastes so sweet when you bite it. Thought you said you would never make a mess.
But now this egg on your face,
defying you, how you always seem to want just one more.
Oh, you want one more?
But I have the egg on my mind. It's great lyrics, great lyrics. All the eggs in my mind.
But honey, I'll look out for them ever I go. But honey, I'll search every shop, down every road. I'm waiting for it, that cream egg.
Treats.
I'm so sorry to everyone.
Better than anything I've ever witnessed ever. That was better than Saturday Night Live in your face.
We did quite well.
We did quite well.
That was a good song. I enjoyed the journey of this.
Yeah,
song.
That was really nice. We really worked together.
Mm.
Very organic.
Very organic.
We should get in the studio.
Between getting on the British Bake Off and... Mm-hmm.
No fielding.
Writing a tune. I think we're going to be spending some time together. I can't stop eating this cream.
Yeah,
it's
no.
so delicious.
I think so. Okay, well, let's have some all-time low and just stuff our faces. Lord, thank you for coming on.
Thank you so much for having me.
Great to see you. I'll see you in the studio this afternoon.
Yes.
We'll write that album together.
Pop to Bake Off.
Yeah,
it's gonna be great.
Perfect. I don't believe in saints.